All right, what is up, guys? So we are back with Ready or Not here. There was an update on the supporter edition test alpha branch, whatever you want to call it. This is, from what they're saying, supposed to be coming to the normal Ready or Not edition in the next couple, week or two. They said apparently they want to release it to this, supporter edition test branch thing, get some kinks worked out, have the player base from there tell them what's going on and if there are bugs and all that good stuff. I apologize, have not been making really any videos and stuff or playing. God dang Rona. After about what, two and a half years working the freaking working amongst the public, finally got me, I think. So past 6 7 days, whatever, I've just been taking it easy, chilling, getting this. It's really just sinuses and stuff now, so I'm just getting that taken care of. But other than that, haven't really been playing much or anything, so I wanted to get this video out with the new update that they had that came out. It's been like 4 days now, 5 days now, something like that, since the update. So let's look real quick what they added. So they have a new pepperball gun. It's kind of weird. Any pepperball guns that I have been accustomed to were just Tippmanns, they were just paintball guns. I guess you could probably spend an extra $200 for this one that looks like a AR, or you could just buy the freaking Tippmann for, $150, whatever the heck they go for now. I don't paintball very much anymore, so I never had Tippmanns. So they have this new pepperball gun. It's, looks like an AR or whatever, magazine fed. They added the Mark I carbine, which I am a huge fan of, for the simple fact that I don't like the way they did the HK. I wish they would have just given you the option to have all black. But it is what it is, so. Huge fan of that. You can actually have a like just a straight black 10.5 inch shorty, without having the like tan accent shit. So, huge fan. They added in the SCAR. This should be the 5.56 variant. Yeah, it looks like it's about should be the 5.56. So they added that in. They have the different buttstock here, so some people may not think it looks like the SCAR because it doesn't have like that traditional SCAR buttstock to it, but it looks pretty nice. Haven't shot them yet, so we'll get to that in a second. And then they added this freaking like AK-74U, looks like something like that, like a new variant. Modernized variant of it or something. What was the AK-74, right? That's like the short variant that they would give like tank crews and shit for the Soviets. Let me take a look real quick. Yeah. So it's like a modernized-ish AK-74U. Submachine guns, they didn't add anything new to that. Shotguns, nothing new there. The handguns. Do-do-do-do. Don't think they added anything new to the handguns either. I don't think that one's new. That one's not new. Yeah, so those aren't new. There's no other like tactical gear or anything like that added. I would like to see them add a 40 mil launcher And not so much for like foam rounds. I mean, they could allow it to where you could take like two different types of ammunition for it or something. But I would like to see a 40 mil launcher and being able to put in like ferret gas rounds. So then, like for house, you could actually pump gas into a room from the door frame or from the window, because all the windows are boarded up in that mission, you know. And ferret rounds are designed to punch through windows, plywood, drywall. And basically what you do is, you know, you shoot it up at an upward angle to where it would be extremely unlikely somebody's head would be there, you know. So you shoot it up at an angle towards the top of the wall or the top of the window, and then it'll punch through, embed itself into the ceiling, and then release the gas from there, or the liquid, whatever type of round it is. So I would like to see that. I would also like to see the gas effects a little bit more, to where if they do add something like that, if you actually do it correctly, like a SWAT team typically would for like a barricaded or something, that if you pumped enough gas into each room, you know, and made sure to hit the sectors, you could actually drive people from certain levels of the residence to other levels of the residence, and then actually have other suspects like come out, or other just civilians who are like, "Hey, I want the fuck out of this," just comes out, and then you can apprehend them at the front door or the rear entrance, whatever it is. And they could do a percentage, you know, where it's like, if you do it effective enough, 30% of the freaking occupants will come out and surrender, and then the rest of them will either, you know, have gas masks or just be the 1% that it doesn't affect, and they're just saying, "Screw it, I'm staying in." I think that'd be, because that's SWAT. If you want a SWAT game, that's SWAT. So, but other than that, let's get to shooting some of these guns. So we have the Mark One up. Let's get it customized a little bit. Okay, so something new. They added in a 1x4 optic, and then also a 1x12 optic. So that's pretty cool. I like running the hollow sight. I'm a fan of hollow sights for CQB. Gives you that nice sight window. Not the biggest fan of EOTech with the hollow sights, though. We'll just go with the meh. We'll go suppressed. We'll get the nice stick in there, and we'll get a flashlight. All right. So I'm gonna modify the other ones so they're set up, and then we'll go down and shoot them. All right. So let's get into it. I don't know if they did anything with the sounds. Kind of sounds like it. They need to fix that still. That's a little annoying. Where, like, that's my rifle's totally not in the way there. He should still be able to have it out. So that's a little annoying. They need to start updating that a little bit. I find myself coming through doorways a lot in this game, and he does that, and I don't like it. You wouldn't be going through the doorway with your weapon raised. You can just as easily bring it from your high ready, just below eye level, and just tuck it in as you come through, so your weapon's still up, and if somebody was within 5, 10 feet of you could still engage them from that position. I don't like it how when you come through he does that. I don't know. It's just weird. But one thing I have noticed, just playing around with the shoot house and stuff, is the sight line bore line which is, so if you see the two dots in the hollow sight, your middle dot, your normal point of aim, is your, let's say it's probably zeroed at 50. So that'll be your 50 to, like, you know, 200. And then the dot just below it will be where you'll aim for your sightline board line within about 10 meters. So if you watch, I'll put the middle reticle right on the line for your A box and watch for the round hits. See how it hit low? So I'm actually a huge fan that they put that in the game. And I'll go to the shoot house real quick just to demonstrate it. Because no, I have not seen a game do this. I really haven't. Our middle reticle right here above his shoulder. So this is going to be right in the face of the hostage taker. And watch where the round hits. Sightline, boreline. So when you're coming in within, you know, 3 feet, you're going to have to aim up here. You're going to have to aim at the top of his forehead to get your round to hit where you want it to. That's... I have not seen any game do that. And, you know, the further back you get, the more your rounds are going to hit center of your reticle where you want it to. But when you're within that, you know, 20 meters, you have to aim just slightly above, you know, and the closer you get in, you got to continue to aim above and remember your sightline, boreline. Otherwise, your rounds are going to be hitting off target from where you want to hit. All right, so we have the scar here. Which again, I'm not really the biggest fan of the buttstock they used, but whatever. I would have liked that classic look. But we'll put this in full auto. Recoil's not too bad on it for the recoil control. Got a little off there. It definitely wants to rise on you. Alright, we'll take out the AK-74 here. That's in full auto, okay. Yeah, it wants to climb on you quite a bit. Oh yeah, she wants to climb on you. Oh yeah, she wants to get away from you, that's for sure. We didn't shoot this in full auto, so we'll hit that real quick. Oh, yeah. That's nice. Okay, so something else that they added into the game are new test locations. So I have not checked these ones out yet. This one's called Valley of the Dolls. They have just barricaded on that one right now. That's the penthouse. Hotel rooms. Where's the other one? Here it is. And they added fast food. Which is also barricaded. Only. The other thing they did is the Wonderly Hills Hotel now has everything. It has the barricaded raid, active shooter, bomb threat, and hostage rescue now. And if you pick active shooter, it sets you up in a different location in the hotel from where you start when you do, like, the barricaded suspects one. They also added... Is it... Yeah, so, not that one. Is it 213? No. I'll find it here in a second. I think it was port, that they added in bomb threat and hostage on port now. I think it was just barricaded and raid, or maybe just raid. I can't remember exactly. And I think that was it for it. But yeah, so they added in, basically for the other maps, they added in the new game mode types, or the whatever you want to call it. They just added them in. So that's cool. So we'll take a look at the Wonderly Hills Hotel real quick and just take a quick peek at Active Shooter and just take a look at the different start point of the map. I'm not going to play it all the way through or anything. Okay, so yeah, you can see this is more of like the traditional videos that we've been seeing when they were putting out the gameplay teasers and whatnot. So we have the front entrance here for the hotel. Hopefully there's nobody here and I can kind of get through here a little bit to check it out. So you can see we have the huge main lobby here. Yeah, that's not openable. Okay, so we got an active shooter. This is the active shooter game mode, and we have somebody actively shooting, so we're going to try to make our way to where the shooting is and just kind of take peeks. We got a man down.
I'm over here! Hands up! Do it now!
Get away from me. One person looks to be unarmed.
Shooting was coming from the right. Yep.
Mission failed.
But yeah, so you guys get the picture. It gives you a new look for the maps, which I think is extremely refreshing and awesome. And I can't wait to play them. Right now, I'm just trying to give you guys a little idea of what the updates to come are. I don't know. The only other thing that I hope that they do, besides like adding in the 40 mil launcher with the ferret rounds and stuff, is add in, because we have a ram, we have a breaching shotgun, is to add in like a hooligan bar, and a rake and break tool. I would really like to see the ability for future houses to not all be boarded up, and to allow you to, like, maybe they could still have curtains covering them and stuff, and allow somebody to bring a rake and break tool, so you can clear out windows, and clear out the curtains and stuff, and port and cover windows, or use them as alternate entry points, if the front and back door are both booby trapped, or, you know, whatever the case is, hostage situation where you want to move away from the two main known entry points that they would expect you from, stuff like that. I would like to see them add that in there. And then I would like to see them add in the Uli, just for the simple fact of, I would like to add the Uli with the caveat to that they actually add in hinges, because if you have a door that opens outward towards you, you know, like, it comes outside, like, you open it from the outside, and it comes out, you know, you could ram it all day, and it might not give, you know? I mean, you'd have to put some serious force on it. So what you would have to do, really, is pry it open. Either that or breach the, you know, take the pins out from the hinges. You could always do that, too. But it's just, to really make the operators think, so then they can see hinges. They can say, hey, hinges are facing out, it's an outward opening. Or, hey, I can't see the hinges, it's inward opening. I would really like to be able to see that and have the guys I play with and stuff to be like, hey, this is what we got, you know, and everybody's on the same page. Because you kind of, the doors just open up both ways, you know. It doesn't really give you that, because that's, as a quote-unquote operator, as a team member for a SWAT team, or anybody that does the military side of it, that does, you know, hostage rescue or CQB, stuff like that, you know, extensively. I'm not sure how much they touch on it in the military with inside and all that good stuff for basic CQB or whatever they do. But that's something you always look for when you're coming up to a door or when you are scoping out the house prior to entry and scouting it. Which sides are the hinges on? Which side is the doorknob on? Is there a screen door? You know, is there a storm door? So on and so forth. And that level of detail, I don't think it'd be too much of a stretch to do to put the hinges, because most interior doors open inward, you know. Most exterior doors open inward, except like your storm door, which would more than likely open outward. But just that level of detail would be pretty cool, because so like a lot of your bedroom doors and stuff will open inward, but obviously like closet doors and stuff usually open outward. But yeah, I think that would add a nice detail to the game to really hone in your CQB skills. But other than that, I think that's really all I got for this one. I just want to give a quick little review of it, let you guys see what's in the pipeline for the main game. And I'm feeling better and stuff, so probably gonna start getting some videos out and all that good stuff. But other than that, I will see you guys in the next one.